What makes you happy or sad? This is a good question that can be discussed over and over again, and still we cannot find an answer to this. People are different in nature. Some of them have only one roof and some basic food, while others live a luxury life with all sorts of entertainment. However, are all of them really happy? This is a big question, as the inner state of happiness does not depend on the amount of money that you have. Happiness differs from person to person. It is cultivated by people during their lifetime. It depends on the lifestyle, life period, and even family values. Do you ever feel unhappy? Happiness is something that we all strive to attain. We must accept the fact that life is short and unhappiness makes it shorter. Circumstances can certainly make life unhappy, but a big part of our unhappiness comes from our thinking, behavior, and habits. Our habits directly impact the quality of the life that we live. In this video, I'd like to share a few destructive habits that can create a bit of nuisance in your own little world and can make you unhappy. We are not just speaking about problems, but we are also speaking about the ultimate solutions to those problems. So if you like my work, then please go ahead and subscribe to this channel for more of these videos. I make this kind of videos on mildly interesting topics, so please subscribe for more of these. So here we start with the 6 destructive habits that destroys happiness. Does life has to be perfect before you're happy? Do you have to behave in a perfect way to get the results and be happy? Then happiness will not be easy to find. Setting the bar for yourself at an inhuman level usually leads to a low self-esteem being created, and you always feel grounded. It creates a feeling that you are not good enough even if you have had a lot of excellent results in the past. You and what you do is never good enough, except once in a while when everything seems perfect. To explain this further, here's a short story. Imagine two people who want to become good writers. The first one spends 1 year to write one perfect story. The other one writes 365 stories, one story every day. At the end of the day, who do you think became a better writer? The second guy became a better writer, the one who wrote many stories and failed multiple times. That same guy improved over time. The only way to improve is through constant practice. If you do something again and again, your failures will become a success. Also, how we talk to ourselves shapes our image for a better or worse. Self-worth is an essential component of happiness, and we all have the right to feel good about ourselves. Realize when mistakes are made, simply accept them and move on. Avoid engaging in negative self-talk. Respect the inherent differences of others and accept their right to live happily without undue criticism. We live in a materialistic world wherein we are constantly bombarded with the advertisements of the latest car, shoes, or even credit cards. All of them promise a happier and an easier existence. We might feel that we require all of this for a happy life. Don't believe it for a second. While purchasing a new product may give you an emotional boost for a second, but it doesn't last forever. Seek joy in something that does not involve whipping out of a piece of plastic. Try out various activities like exercising, reading, or sightseeing. Seek satisfaction without accompanying debt. While we aim for a perfect life with all the luxuries of life, we are simply ignoring all the small elements of life which are meant to give us happiness. Don't strive for perfection, but strive for progress. It's not about perfection, but it's about making a positive change. Have no fear of perfection, because you will never reach there. The more you strive for perfection, the more you're dragging yourself away from progress. Strive to be the best version of yourself, and you will be a much more happier person. Who we socialize with, what we read, and what we listen to has got a great impact on the way we think and live. It becomes a lot harder to stay happy if you're constantly being dragged down by negative voices. Voices that tell you that life in large part would be unhappy, unfair, or even filled with lots of difficulties. Voices that will watch life from a negative perspective. Happy people don't complain much, nor do successful people. On the other hand, chronic complainers always have got something negative to say, even if people around them are happy. We all have different circumstances in this lifetime, but at the end of the day, these circumstances are ours. Fair or unfair, wanted or unwanted, we must accept them. Seek simple solutions to problems instead of complaining about them and staying unhappy. Replacing those negative voices with positive ones is very important. It can be like a whole new world opening up for you. So spend more time with positive people, inspiring music and books, movies and TV shows that make you laugh and think about life in a new way. Leave all those negative self-harming addictions and people in the past and start a new life. You can start small, one step at a time. For example, try reading some uplifting blog posts or watch some motivational videos. Listen to an audiobook tomorrow morning with a cup of tea instead of watching the latest updates of COVID-19. Spending much of your time in the past and reliving old conflicts, memories, or even missed opportunities can hurt you a lot. Spending much of your time in the future and imagining how things could go wrong at work, in your relationship, or in your health can create self-doubt and build into horrifying nightmare scenarios, and it keeps playing in your head over and over again. Not being here in life as it happens can lead to missing out on a lot of opportunities which today's time has to offer. This is not at all good if you want to stay happy. Regret is not really useless, but it's also harmful. Research continues to show that repetitive negative thoughts about decisions made in the past often precedes chronic stress and depression. According to psychology, there are 4 ways to deal with regret. Learn from the mistakes but don't dwell on them. If nothing can be changed about the situation, let it go. Make sure you're not assigning too much blame on yourself and reframe the situation more positively. Every day we face so many obstacles which helps us to grow and to define who we really are. If I hold this glass of water in my hand and if I ask you guys what is the weight of this water, you all might have different answers, but the absolute weight of this glass doesn't matter. It totally depends on how long I can hold onto it. If I hold onto it for a minute, nothing happens. But if I hold onto it for an hour, my arm will begin to pain. But if I hold onto it all day long, my arm will feel numb and paralyzed. Well, the weight of this glass hasn't changed, but the longer I hold onto it, the heavier it becomes. The stress of the past and the worries of the future are just like this glass of water. If you think about them for a while, there is no problem. But if you think about them for a minute, it begins to hurt. But if you think about them all day long, you will feel paralyzed and incapable of doing anything. So it is better to simply put down this glass of water and to stop worrying about the past or the future and live in today's time. Live in the present. What we can do is we can live in today's time by exercising God-given talents and abilities. This enables us to live a happier life existence. Face difficulties as they arise and simply move on with your life. Enjoy the beautiful things and enjoy them fully. It is pretty much impossible to stop worrying about the past or the future, and it is of course important to plan for tomorrow and the next day and also learn from the mistakes that you did yesterday. But don't dwell on these things. Try spending the major part of your day by living in now. One very common and destructive daily habit is to constantly compare you and your life to others and their life. People usually compare cars, houses, shoes, money, relationships, social popularity, and so on. At the end of the day, you degrade your self-esteem to the ground level and you're left with a lot of negative feelings. Nothing gives you more insecurity feeling than indulging in a small negative self-talk about others as well as yours. After all, would a happy person indulge in something that is of no benefit to him? Leave gossip for school kids at recess. It doesn't suit a person like you who is trying every single day to make a major change in your life. Similar to other feelings, holding grudges against anyone is just like holding a weight on your back as you climb the mountain of happiness. We all witness negative behaviors of people and can become angered as a result. But always remember that it's not just about ignorant behavior, but it's also about your own happiness. Either forget or ignore and simply move on with your life. Instead of comparing yourself to others, compare yourself to yourself. See how much you have grown, what have you accomplished, and what progress you have made towards achieving your goals. This habit has the benefit of creating gratitude, appreciation, and kindness towards yourself as you observe how far you have come, obstacles that you have faced, and the good stuff that you have done. You feel good about yourself without having to think negative or even bad about other people. Be kind and stay humble. In my experience, the way you behave and think towards others seems to have a big effect on how you behave towards yourself and think about yourself. Judge and criticize others more and you tend to judge and criticize yourself more. Be kind to other people and help them and you tend to be more kind and helpful towards yourself. Focus on the positive things and the positive people around you. Appreciate whatever is positive in yourself and others. And always remember that you can't always win when you keep comparing yourself to others. Reminding this to yourself can be really helpful. No matter whichever great talent or skill you have, there is always someone who is far better than you. If you think that the world revolves around you and you constantly hold yourself back because you're afraid what people might think or do if you say something that's different, then you're putting some big limits on your life. You become less open to trying out new things and growing as a person. You might think that the criticism and the negativity that you encounter is all about you and it's all your fault. I have found that my shyness used to come from me thinking that people cared a great deal about whatever I would do or whatever I would say. It requires no great effort to get caught in the daily activity of life. Working, eating, sleeping, maybe a day or two of doing something fun and relaxing, but not directing our talent and our passion to a tangible goal, we are likely to miss out on a lot of opportunities which comes our way. The hardest part of achieving something is to take the first initial step. After setting a game plan and after taking that first initial step, only we can see some possibilities. Realize that people don't care too much about what you do. They have their hands full of worries about their own life and what would people think of them instead. This may make you feel less important, but it gives you confidence and a freedom to do whatever you want. Focus outward. Instead of thinking about yourself and how people would perceive you all the time, focus outward on people around you. Listen to them and help them. It will help you to raise your self-esteem and to reduce your self-centered focus. Life is pretty much simple and we make it complicated. This is what creates stress and unhappiness. But much of them is often created by us. Yes, the world might be turning more complex day by day, but that doesn't mean that we cannot create new habits that make our own life a bit simpler. When we find ourselves unhappy and discontent, our first reaction is entirely emotional. In other words, we blow out things from our own proportion. Just take a step back, focus entirely on the problem, and think about an ultimate solution. Overcomplicating life may involve a lot of bad habits, but I would like to mention a few good habits that has helped me to overcome this particular problem. Avoid focusing on multiple things and do one thing at a time. Avoid having too many alternatives. Avoid creating relationship problems of any kinds in your mind. Don't get lost in stress and overwhelm later. Try spending less time scrolling on social media or in the virtual world and enjoy the real world. Life is a gift and the same remains with us with a great endurance only when we have the power to make ourselves happy and to make others happy. There is no big magic in making someone happy. Happiness lies within. We can be happy with the little things that we do and see in life. This is why it is always good to have clean habits, good hobbies, and be surrounded by wise friends. When we are circled with good, we lead a happy life. If we are selfish, it's likely that we lose out on a lot of good friends, and it's not a sign of a happy life. A baby is always happy because he or she always focuses on the good things. The secret to a happy life can be unfolded if we accept things in life. We should be ready to accept both positive and negative things of life and think about the next step immediately. We must be able to set an example for others and make them realize that happiness is the root of life. Make a decision to be cheerful in whichever situation you find yourself. If you believe that you have gained the awareness into any of these habits, then keep them at bay by following the same above mentioned points. That's all I have for this video. I'll see you in the next one. And then keep smiling, keep spreading smiles, and stay happy all day, every day, everywhere.